Hi everyone, Ladislas Maurice from thewanderinginvestor.com here. So I'm spending a week in the Canary Islands in Spain off the West African coast. So to be clear, I didn't come here for investment purposes. The weather was simply horrendous in Europe and I came here for a week to get some sunshine. Friends of mine contacted me on Instagram, they saw my stories and were like, Ladislas, what about real estate there? So here I am doing a little report on real estate. So I'll start off with a little overview on the real estate market in the Canary Islands. So specifically here in Grand Canaria, one of the main islands. Then I'll go into why I would not invest in real estate in the Canary Islands. And then lastly, I'll discuss for who it actually could be interesting, because it in some cases, moving here can be good for some people. As with the rest of Spain, the real estate market in the Canary Islands peaked in 2008 at approximately 1,800 euros per square meter. And then the financial crisis happened and prices crashed 30% to 1,250 a square meter in 2012. And then from 2012 to 2020, there was a slow, gradual increase up to an average of approximately 1,600 euros per square meter. And with the whole situation, prices haven't gone up, they haven't really gone down, they've just flattened. So there are no screaming buying opportunities currently. Now, what's very important to note about the Canary Islands, so specifically here, Grand Canaria, is that it's a two-tier real estate market. On the one hand, you've got real estate for locals, where locals live and work, etc. And then you have the real estate market that targets foreigners and tourists, and they're very different. So for example, I went to Las Palmas, the capital city here on this island. The island has about 850,000 people living here. And you could find apartments for 700 euros a square meter in the outskirts. In those cases, the apartments really looked like social housing. Like you were really aiming for the bottom with these apartments. You wouldn't really want to live there, honestly. Prime real estate in Las Palmas, the capital city, you could find for approximately 2,000 euros a square meter, but the city doesn't really have much to offer. And personally, I would not invest in the local market in Spain. Like, why would anyone invest in the local market in Spain? The debt to GDP ratio is going to hit 120% this year. The fertility rate is extremely low. The latest figures are, I think, 1.26 births per woman in Spain, which is extremely low. So it's an indebted nation, old people. People are not reproducing. And honestly, the whole country is a basket case. It's just living off EU transfers and EU subsidies. Like, I would challenge, and please, I would challenge people watching this video, name just a success story coming out of Spain. I can only think of Zara and some of the football teams. But please, if you can think of anything else, please put in the comments. And also, specifically related to the Canary Islands, like the economy has just been decimated here. It's completely devastated. I was looking at some numbers. Only 30% of hotels are currently opened. And of those that are opened, they have only a 40% occupancy rate, which is extremely low. And here we are at Puerto Rico. It's one of the main resort cities in Grand Canary. It targets families. It's usually packed, and this is a Saturday. The beach is not full. You can tell here all the little restaurants and stores, they're all closed. We'll see later, even the local McDonald's is closed. The food stalls are all closed down there. Even the supermarkets, it's just terrible. Like completely, completely devastated. So what we're gonna do now is we're just gonna walk to a real estate agency and we're just gonna go window shopping just to show you the type of apartments that you can get in such a resort, what they look like, and the price per square meter. You'll see it's really not interesting. Just look at this. Look at what governments have done. All these businesses are closed. We're on the main beach. Everything's closed. And it's a Saturday. So on Saturdays, even locals go to the beach, but that market is just too small to even sustain these shops. So Puerto Rico is one of the nicer resorts in the Canary Islands. And this is what the marina looks like. Look, I don't want to be critical. People like their boats. I don't have a boat myself. But objectively, this does not scream of luxury, of money, of anything. These boats are all very average. I'd even dare to say below average. If you go to Egypt, if you go to Montenegro, you'll see boats that are 10 times nicer than this. And just looking around, look, this place looks like it peaked in the 80s, maybe early 2000s. Look, the beach is nice, don't get me wrong. But the architecture of these buildings is, I mean, you can tell everything peaked a while ago. Just looking at these buildings, they have very little architectural value. So it's not like buying a historical building in the center of Budapest, for example, where the architecture of the building appreciates in value. Here, the actual buildings depreciate very quickly. They're, I don't know, 20 years old. They already look awful, and in 10 years from now, they'll look even worse. Do you think that the current generation Z, for example, will appreciate this sort of architecture in the next 10, 20 years once they actually have money to invest? I honestly only see boomers potentially liking this. Millennials, probably not. And you know your economy is in trouble when even McDonald's is closed. So Saturday afternoon, sunny day by the beach, closed. And it's not because of restrictions. Restaurants are allowed to open, etc. It's just the economy is just horrible. So I went to a few agencies, and these listings here are fairly representative. I have an apartment, a bit of a view. You're looking at approximately 2,500 euros a square meter for this one. Honestly, it's the best deal I've seen. Because typically, looking here, I mean, this one, more than almost 4,000 euros a square meter. This one, like approximately 3,000 euros a square meter. So it's in these old buildings. This is what you get, essentially. So quite frankly, I don't see any potential for capital gains here. Look, maybe if interest rates go even lower, based on fundamentals, I really do not see any interesting potential. Also bear in mind that as soon as you buy here in Spain, there's a 6.5% transfer tax. So you're immediately down 6.5%. If you were somehow to manage to make capital gains, there are capital gains taxes, you'd have to pay the agency, etc. So if you buy here, it's gonna take a while to make money, if ever, honestly. I also don't see the value for wealthy people of moving to Spain. The income, personal income tax rates are really high. As soon as you earn 60,000 euros a year or more, you get slapped with a 45% income tax rate, which is absolutely horrific. And there are heavy capital gains taxes as well on stocks and et cetera, et cetera. So look, if you've got money and you like it here, sure, you can buy a place and spend 2-3 months of the year making sure that you don't become a tax resident here. Look, the reality is it's not a bad place. I don't find the beaches very appealing. It's all a bit stuck in the past, but inland hiking is absolutely wonderful. The mountains are stunning, the little villages. Essentially every day I went hiking. I didn't actually even go to the beach once. I was just hiking every day. Really enjoyed my time here. So the reality is the Canary Islands does have a space, and I'd say it's for middle class Europeans who have retired and they just get a normal pension, and they maybe they have one or two rental apartments back home, and with double tax agreements they don't actually pay extra taxes or anything, and instead of living in Eindhoven or Düsseldorf or Belgium, then you know they can live in the Canary Islands, year-round sunshine. Honestly, it's really cheap here. You can get a coffee for 1 euro. I even saw places for 80 cents. There are cheap shops like Little is here, so shopping is really affordable. There is a very, the VAT rate is low in the Canary Islands. They have a special rate, only 7%. So from a shopping perspective, it's quite attractive. Gas is cheap as well. So look, it makes sense for such people. If you're retired, instead of being somewhere in Northern Europe with terrible weather and high taxes, you just move to somewhere with good weather and high taxes, but where life is also a bit cheaper. So from that point of view, it makes sense. There are also some special economic zones whereby if you incorporate a company here, you can get tax rates of 4%, corporate income tax rates of 4%, which is actually probably the lowest in the European Union. But for that, you need to hire a few people, and then you yourself would probably need to spend quite a bit of time in Spain, which would mean becoming a tax resident on a personal basis, which again doesn't quite make sense. So honestly, look, Canary Islands for me, if you ask me, it's a hiking destination. It is certainly not a place for people with money to spend too much time or invest, but it does make sense for some Europeans. And by the way, the top four purchasers of real estate here in terms of foreigners are Italians, number one, two, British, three, German, and four, Belgium. And I completely understand why people from Belgium would want to leave Belgium. All right, I hope you like this this content. I have quite a lot of trips planned for this summer in Europe, so stay tuned, and as always, make sure to sign up to the private list on thewanderinginvestor.com. It's entirely free, and this way you won't miss out on any of the analysis as I travel around the world looking at citizenship, investment, and second residency options. Cheers.